Midnight.
Hello there, everyone, and welcome to another video. My name is Tyler, and I'm trying something a little different today. And I would love your opinion on it. I, instead of using a spreadsheet where I keep all my notes, I actually made a slideshow, and it worked out really well. Let's see what you think.
YouTube content Google's blank document content edit multi.
So what we're going to talk about today is the history facts for today, August 15th, 2021. And there at the bottom, if you can see it, we have the link of the source material, the Associated Press, www.ap.org. So there is my source.
Slide 2 of 18, 1057, Macbeth, King of Scots, was killed in battle by Malcolm, the eldest son of King Duncan, whom Macbeth had slain. Layout, title and body, two objects on the page selected.
In 1057, Macbeth, King of Scots, was killed by Duncan, or was killed by, hold on.
Slide 2 of 18, 1057, Macbeth, King of Scots,
Macbeth,
was killed
King
in battle
of Scots,
by Malcolm,
by the, Malcolm eldest son, the eldest son of Duncan, whom Macbeth had previously killed. So it was a revenge killing. That's always lovely.
Slide 3 of 1819, 14.
In 1914,
the Panama Canal
officially
opened as the SS
Anchon
crossed the just completed waterway between the Pacific.
As the SS, well, you can literally read it, but as the SS Anchon crossed the waterway between the Atlantic and Pacific. So there you go, Lewis and Clark. You finally have a passageway between the Atlantic and Pacific. It's only a couple hundred years late. Womp womp.
Slide 4 of 18, 1935. Humorist Will Rogers and aviator Wiley Post were killed when their airplane crashed near Point Barrow in the Alaska Territory. Layout, title.
So humor, what I find weird is when they look at history, historical facts, they don't call them comedians, they call them humorists. So a humorist and a navigator were killed. It's probably fancier to say that. I have never heard of, how do I read this by character?
Slide 3 of 1819. Slide 4 of 1835. Humorist Will Rogers.
I've heard of Will Rogers, but I've never, you know, seen his work. Maybe I'll look him up later and check him out. If anyone has seen his work, let me know.
Slide 5 of 1839. The MGM musical The Wizard of Oz.
The Wizard of Oz premiered at the Chinese Grauman Theater in Hollywood in 1939. That's how old that movie is. And that's Judy Garland at her best, in my opinion.
Slide 6 of 18, 1944. During World War II, Allied forces landed in southern France in Operation Dragoon.
Allied forces landed in southern France in 1944 in Operation Dragoon, which that's different than D-Day. I wonder if it took them that long to go from D-Day to France. It's kind of interesting to think about, isn't it?
Slide 7 of 18, 1945 in a pre-recorded radio.
1945, Emperor Hirohito said that Japan had agreed to the terms of the United States, effectively ending World War II.
Slide 8 of 18, 1947,
India became independent. India became independent, so happy Independence Day to India.
New notification from Google Chrome. New notification. Details are...
India became independent. We will look at that notification later. India became independent after several hundred years of British rule. So happy birthday. Happy Independence Day to our brothers and sisters in India.
Slide 9 of 18, 1969.
Woodstock! There we go. Woodstock started up today in 1969. And it was something, wasn't it? Maybe I'll do some research on that and do a video on that one. Woodstock was fun.
Slide 10 of 18, 1970.
I don't really understand what happened here in 1971, why Richard Nixon decided to put a moratorium on wages, rents, and costs of goods. Were we in a recession at that time? I'm not 100% sure. Maybe I'll dig a little deeper into that one, or someone in the comments section can let me know.
Slide 11 of 18, 1998, 29 people.
1998, the saddest story of the entire day. of all of these, 1998, 29 people were killed when a car bomb exploded in Northern Ireland. A group calling itself the Real, ILO. Is it ILO or ILF? Hold on.
Slide 12 of 18, 2000. Slide 10 of 18, 1970. Slide 11 of 18, 1998. 29 people were killed by a car bomb that tore apart the center of Omagh, Omagh, Northern Ireland.
Thanks, Mark.
A splinter group calling itself the Real IRA claimed responsibility.
IRA.
Layout, title.
The Real IRA claimed responsibility. That is simply terrible. What do we have next here, Mark? Mark is the voice you hear reading all this stuff.
Slide 12 of 18, 2003. Bouncing back from the largest.
Oh, yeah. The light. When the lights went out. That was absolutely insane. I remember that. I was really little, but I remember the stories on the news all about the lights going out and just being out in the middle of summer. But luckily, they started to come back today, and all the power crews got everything back up. So, yay! Now we move over to the year...
Slide 13 of 18, 2015.
What's 2015?
Japanese Emperor Akihito expressed...
Japanese Emperor Akihito actually had to cover for his prime minister, who refused to acknowledge the fact that apologized to people, family members of victims during the Japanese atrocities. So let's actually listen to Mark read that.
Slide 13 of 18, 2015, Japanese Emperor Akihito expressed rare deep remorse over his country's wartime actions in an address marking the 70th anniversary of Japan's surrender in World War II, a day after the Prime Minister fell short of apologizing to victims of Japanese aggression. Civil rights leader Julian Bond, 75, died in Fort Walton Beach, Florida.
Civil rights leader Julian Bond, I'm not sure how to pronounce it, died in Florida at the age of 75. Also in 2015, we have another baseball story coming up here, so...
Slide 14 of 18, 2017. President Donald Trump, who'd faced harsh criticism for initially blaming the deadly week...
Now we get into a... I remember this story. 2017, Donald Trump, his line about there were very good people on both sides of the Charlottesville riot, that... was that occurred today. So we're just going to move on from that.
Slide 15 of 18, 2011, hitting back against an embolden.
So 2011, President Obama, sorry, it's out of order. Source material kind of went out of order and I didn't want to move the slides. 2011, President Obama basically... in some sort of economic thing about economic, like, not tariffs. Let's take a listen. Come on.
Slide 16 of 18, 2016. Slide 15 of 18, 2011, hitting back against an emboldened GOP. President Barack Obama launched a rare direct attack on the Republican presidential field, criticizing his potential 2012 rivals for their blanket opposition to any deficit-cutting compromise involving new taxes. His comments came during a...
So blanket deafening compromise, so to lower the spending on taxes. Okay. I don't really understand economics that well. I'm going to be real with y'all. I don't get it. When they start talking that kind of economics, my brain just goes blah, 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 blah. So let's see if there's another fact.
Slide 15 of 18, 2011, hitting back against an emboldened GOP. President Barack Obama launched a rare direct attack on the Republican presidential field, criticizing...
I should have honestly separated the two of them. Now that I'm actually making the video, I should have honestly separated the two of them in their own thing, just labeled it the same thing, because this is crazy. Damn it.
Slide 15 of 18, 2011, hitting back against an emboldened GOP. President Barack Obama launched a rare direct attack on the Republican presidential field, criticizing his potential 2012 rivals for their blanket opposition to any deficit-cutting compromise involving new taxes. His comments came during a town hall-style meeting in Cannon Falls, Minnesota. Jim Thome, Tommy, hit his 600th home run an inning after he hit number 599 to...
Jim Tommy hit his 600th home run, as you could hear Mark read it, an inning after he hit his 599th. So that's a pretty cool historical fact.
Slide 16 of 18, 2016, Republican Donald Trump called for extreme ideological vetting of immigrants.
In 2016, future President Donald Trump and Republican nominee called for extreme ideological vetting to determine if people are extremists or if they have American values. I will let Mark actually read it because I can't do it justice.
Slide 16 of 18, 2016, Republican Donald Trump called for extreme ideological vetting of immigrants seeking admission to the United States, vowing during a speech in Youngstown, Ohio, to significantly overhaul the country's screening process and block those who sympathized with extremist groups or didn't embrace American values. President Barack Obama, in Chilmark, Massachusetts.
And then on the same day, we have President Obama basically saying that if we don't do our best, Democrats, then Hillary Clinton could lose. We know that she did lose. Spoiler alert, she did lose. But I'm not sure if it was I don't really follow the statistics of data that well.
Slide 17 of 18, 2020, President Donald Trump's younger brother, businessman Robert Trump, died after being hospitalized in New York. He was 71. Firefighters struggled to contain three wildfires.
In 2020, in addition to everything else that happened in that lovely, freaky, deaky year, President Donald Trump's younger brother, Robert Trump, passed away. Doesn't say from what, but he did pass away in a hospital in New York. And then firefighters were continuing to deal with three massive fires in California.
Slide 18 of 18, what you can do. Slide 17 of 18, 2020, President Donald Trump's younger brother, businessman Robert Trump, died after being hospitalized in New York. He was 71. Firefighters struggled to contain three wildfires near Los Angeles, as forecasters warned that the risk of new fires was high. Layout, type.
So, if you found this video helpful in any manner whatsoever, or if you like the new layout, the new system, here are some things you can do.
Slide 18 of 18, what you can do. 1 point, like the video. 2 points,
like subscribe
the video, to the channel.
You can subscribe to the channel, or you could leave a comment. I would really appreciate all of those. Leaving a comment, subscribing to the channel, and especially liking the video, leaving a comment, because it helps me improve it helps me improve my videos. I would love to know from a visual perspective, is this a good idea? Should I turn off Mark from reading things and just have the speech, have the text come across the screen and read it that way? Let me know what you would like to see. I think I might turn off Mark for the next one. Anyway, thank you all for watching and have a pleasant day.
Bookmarks, Google Chrome. Screen recorder. 1326. Button stop.